Ariana Grande and Pete Davidson are engaged after just a few weeks of dating.
A lot of people recognize you as Ariana Grande's fiance.
First one, first and only. I did that for America.
I got jump-started by Ariana. I scare people because I have like a lot of issues.
Some dark shit out there, man. I'm so sorry. I'm falling apart. People gotta be nicer.
Ariana said she dated him as a distraction.
Where did she say this stuff? To her friends? In the confidence of her own home? No, she said it on the cover of Vogue magazine.
Police received a 911 call from an unidentified male.
All I do know is that she really loved him.
I had a very chill childhood up until that.
Witnesses on social media report hearing a loud bang, possibly an explosion.
People are permanently affected by this. It changes your life quite a bit, you know?
Like, I pretty much knew it was around over after that. That was horrible.
The world was devastated by the events of September 11th. But for Pete, the tragedy was deeply personal.
Pete is from Staten Island. His father was a fireman who lost his life on 9/11.
For the most part, it was just a normal Staten Island family. There wasn't too much darkness. I had a very chill childhood.
Yeah.
Up until that.
His father died a hero and left Pete living in his shadow.
I had a really rough time in high school. I still have PTSD from that. It was so confusing because, like, my dad just died.
9/11's mentioned on a weekly basis. It made it impossible for me to grieve. The New York way of dealing with things is just distraction, and then you never deal with it.
Unable to feel, Pete began harming himself.
So you think that you're trying to match physical pain with emotional?
But one thing rescued him from despair.
The first time I was ever happy was going to an open mic and just trying out a joke, and it got like a little bit of a giggle. That feeling's the best.
When his career as a comedian took off, Pete met his dream girl.
Ariana, the first time you appeared on Saturday Night Live, she was the guest singer, I guess.
Yeah, I was just like staring at her.
And after Ariana broke up with her boyfriend, Mac Miller, Pete's dream came true.
Because you have low self-esteem, yeah. I would never think in a million years that I could date Ariana Grande, who's gorgeous and talented. Yeah. How do you know how to get that going?
I didn't. Timing, I feel like, is everything, and we both were in a similar situation at the same time.
Ariana was also healing from trauma.
Witnesses on social media report hearing a loud bang, possibly an explosion.
There has been a deadly incident at an arena in Manchester, England, where pop star Ariana Grande was holding a concert.
You wanted to talk about it?
It's like so hard, whatever you want. Some dark shit out there, man.
Pete thought that he could be Ariana's hero.
I just think like some people are meant to be together.
How did you know Pete was the one for you?
It's just like a feeling, you know?
Believing he had rescued her, Pete was looking forward to a happy life with Ariana.
I just thought he was so cute. I was like, I'm gonna marry that man. He just ticks every box and just gets better every day.
But shortly after their engagement, the unthinkable happened.
Rapper Mac Miller is dead at age 26. Miller died of an apparent overdose.
On social media, many fans blame Miller's death on ex-girlfriend Ariana Grande.
She's having mixed emotion. It's a major punch in the gut for her, and she's trying to make sense of it all, yet it's all too heartbreaking. Pete has been a huge support system for Ariana during this difficult time. He's been very understanding as he knows what grief is like as he's been through it himself. Pete is also trying to shield Ariana from fans who are pinning Mac's death against her.
As hard as Pete tried to save Ariana from her darkness, there was nothing he could do. He had failed her.
It's also about personal demons and anxiety and more intimate tragedies as well, you know? Mental health is so important.
I was like, listen, I get it. Do whatever you gotta do. I'll be here until, like, you don't want me to be here. Like, I pretty much knew it was around over after that. That was really horrible. All I do know is that she really loved him and she wasn't, like, putting on a show, right?
And when Pete and Ariana broke up, all of his pain came rushing back.
Well, my rock bottom is when people are scared of my life and I have to go away, and then I have to bring myself back up again.
Pete disappeared from work, and Ariana worried for his safety.
The New York Police Department performed a wellness check on Pete Davidson after he posted an alarming note on Instagram in which he said, "I really don't want to be on this earth anymore."
With his life spiraling out of control, Pete knew he needed help.
Some people are sad. Some people kind of work and figure their stuff out. And the beautiful thing about rehab is, like, it gets you sober so they can figure out what the problem is.
How often do you still battle with depression?
Oh, I'm always depressed, all the time. I have to constantly bring myself out of it.
While in rehab, Pete saw how he never fully healed from his father's tragic death. Knowing he had to move on, Pete began writing a movie about 9/11.
The movie is my love letter to my mom and trying to end that part of my life.
But making the movie meant Pete would have to face the biggest challenge of his life.
The hard part was being in the firehouse, because I don't go to the firehouse. I had to hang out with those boys again. It was really nerve-wracking at first. These guys haven't seen me in 20 years.
For a pivotal role in the movie, Pete hired actor Steve Buscemi, who was also deeply connected to 9/11.
So I was down at the site, and I was just trying to help out there in any way that I could.
As Pete learned more about his father through filming, Steve was there to help him heal.
His dad has been put on a pedestal all these years, but he wants to really know him. He had his issues. Yeah, he was goofy, just like you, but don't ever forget who he was. He was heroic.
It made me realize that he had his own issues and had problems just like everybody else, but it also made me realize that even with all that, his morals were still intact. None of that prevented him from being a hero.
It was really so hard for him to recover, and I would even say it's just been recently that he's finding his way and being okay.
I feel like maybe we got to a place where we could finally let go.
And despite the painful breakup, Pete was able to make peace with Ariana.
I've been very fortunate and lucky to date some really wonderful, talented women.
Pete Davidson, thanks for existing.
Pete's story shows us that you need to face your pain in order to heal.
You grow a lot as a person. You become a better version of yourself.
It always gets better. It'll get worse again, too, but it always gets a lot better.
And that true heroism is about helping others as well as yourself.
I'm definitely working on trying to love myself more. I can help anybody, I'm all for it, always.
One of the main goals of this film was to allow me to let go of a lot of my issues and, like, you know, just put it all out there and have people, you know, see it. So a lot of people struggle with mental illness and anxiety and depression, and, you know, to bring light to it is something we really wanted to do, to let people know that they aren't alone.